partners, and thank you so much for joining us. On behalf of Bishop Michael A. Strickland and Lady Brenda Strickland, we are so grateful that you are here with us for our victorious encounter at home, where we stand in our faith, we confess with our mouths, and we believe that God will show up for us in a big and mighty way. Now, while you are preparing for today's dynamic experience, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and share to ensure more souls are reached. Now grab your family, grab your friends, grab your notebook and your paper, whatever it is that you need to prepare for this encounter. Remember, we have a charge to keep. So let's get it.
find your victory in Him. Can we just worship God right here?
Come on. Jesus, thank you, Lord Jesus. There's victory in Jesus. There's victory in Jesus. the first month we're in. And if you are still here, you want to tell the Lord, thank you that I believe. And you want to have a grateful heart today. Yeah, and tell the Lord, thank you that I made it. Hey, God, I'm grateful this morning. I'm grateful this morning. Section and then go to your page and post it, and then once you post it, tag the bishop in it. Amen. Tag somebody in it who's on your timeline and tell them this is how we do it on the fifth Sunday. Amen. This is how we do it on the fifth Sunday. Amen.
The Lord is indeed in this place this morning, and I know the victory belongs to Jesus. And I have even greater news. The Lord is still blessing victory to be a blessing to others. So keep your seat. Let's take a listen.
Ladies, have you registered? Because on this Tuesday, February 2nd, the Heart to Heart Women's Ministry Book Club will begin a new study from the book, The Deborah Anointing by Michelle McLean Walters. If you're registered, that's great. But if not, please visit our website at igotthevictory.org and click on the banner. Registration is free, but you must be registered to attend. We're looking forward to seeing each of you on Tuesday. Attention all couples. Make plans to join us for the Two Become One Couples Cooking, hosted by Bishop Michael and Lady Brenda Strickland. This virtual event will take place via Zoom on Saturday, February 13th at 7 p.m. This will be a fun and intimate time to celebrate your marriage and strengthen your love. Please visit mastrickland.com to register. Volunteers are needed this afternoon from 12 to 3 p.m. for our Community Restoration Day, as Victory Cares will go out to feed the homeless in our community. Your support is greatly appreciated. For more information on what's going on at the V, please visit our website at www.igotthevictory.org. And remember, 2021 is our year of restoration.
So we give God praise, we give Him thanks, we give Him glory, and we give Him honor for the wonderful things that He's doing in each of our lives. Now let me share with you the word of the living God that He has given me on today. We do have our affirmation. Amen. I'm going to try to hold my mic this way today. I'm going to try to hold it down. Amen. If I get in a little trouble, y'all just tell me. I want you to know that in this season of our lives, that we want to be a vessel that will honor God. I want you to know we want to be a vessel that will honor God. Amen.
Yes, yes.
So we want to be sanctified and holy. Listen, now, I know y'all not used to hearing those words anymore in 2021, but you got to be holy.
Yes,
yes. The Bible declares, "Be ye holy, for I am holy," saith the Lord. A vessel of honor for God.
Yes.
It was the right Reverend Dr. Archbishop Jim Lee Smith who I heard sing this. A vessel of honor for I can't be. thank you now for your name among men. We give you praise, we give you glory, and we give you honor. For what you are about to say to us, for what you are about to do among us, we thank you today. Amen. We glorify you all today. And we lift your name high, declaring there's no other God like you in all the earth. There's nobody like you in all the earth. There's nobody like you in all the earth. We bless your name, Jesus. We honor your name, Jesus. So ask to speak to us, say all in this place. We give you praise, we give you glory, and we give you honor in Jesus' name. And the people of God said amen. They said amen again.
Amen.
Right there where you are, shout amen one more time.
Amen.
Amen. Shall we stand and do our affirmation on today? Amen. Get your Bibles out, get your devices out, get yourselves ready that we might hear the word of the living God. Come on, y'all, let's do our affirmation. Let's affirm this. Together, we're going to say it together. I think I'm going to say it. I want you to say it after me. Amen.
This is the word of God that shall stand forever. It is the incorruptible seed that shall grow if I believe. Today, I prepare the soil of my heart to receive the word of God. I am what the word says I am. I am doing what it says I can do. My faith is released and my heart is ready to receive. This word, seed shall produce a harvest. In Jesus' name, let's get it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to talk to you today about where do we go from here? Where do we go from here? Where do we go from here? It was the theme song in the movie Mahogany that asked the question, do you know where you're going to? Do you like the things that life is showing you? Do you know where are you going to? Do you get what you're hoping for when you look behind you? There's no open door. What are you hoping for? And the question was, do you know? And I believe that this theme song asks an appropriate question that I think a lot of people are asking as it relates to the next moves for the body of Christ in our local assemblies and global. Somebody said, where do we go from here? We spent a season in our ministry where I believed that God was doing three things. He was sifting, he was shifting, and he was lifting. And I believe, like Paul said, he says, I don't mind repeating what I have written in earlier letters, and I hope you don't mind hearing it again. Better safe than sorry. So here it is. I believe God is doing three things. He is sifting. That means he's separating. He is shifting. That means he is causing some change to take place. And he is lifting. Somebody say, elevation belongs to me. And I want you to hear me say that if you're going to be elevated, it comes from the Lord, all God all by himself. Listen, promotion only comes from the Lord God all by himself. So he will raise up somebody. Listen, who will find you where you are. And I want to prophesy and release it over your life that somebody's looking for you right now. Somebody's looking for you right now. And so I believe that God is doing some things in our lives. Somebody said, do it, God. But I believe that when the dust settles, I believe we need some sense of directions for the saints. When the dust settles, I believe we need some direction for the saints. And every year as a ministry, we spend this Sunday sharing with our partners and you, our friends, what we believe the Lord's direction is for our house and where do we see us growing in this season. And I believe that if you give God something to work with, somebody say, give him something to work with. I believe if you give God something to work with, he'll show up in a miraculous way. I'm going to try it again. Do I have any believers? If you give God something to work with, he'll show up in a miraculous way. He'll move in a supernatural moment. He'll manifest the big in a big way. If you give him something to work with, somebody shout, give him something to work with. Yeah, yeah. So we want to give God something to work with. And I believe we've entered this season declaring and believing that God will restore some things in our lives. Somebody say, restore it, God. And so our working definition is restoration is to receive back more than that has been lost to the point where the final state is greater than the original condition. It is to receive back. Somebody say, I want it all back. Somebody shout, I want it all back. Somebody shout, I want it all back. It is to receive back more than has been lost to the point where the final state is greater than the original condition. And we want this restoration to be improved beyond its original state. Somebody say, improve it, God. Is there anybody in here with me that you can believe God for it to be better than it was before something caused it to be restored? Is anybody here who feels like God's going to restore that thing for you? I feel the Holy Ghost right here. Is there anybody who's bold enough to stand on your feet and declare, God, restore it for me? Yes, yes, yes. God, I need a restorative move. I need some restoration in my marriage. I need a restoration in my family. God, I need better finances. I need some restoration in my home. I need some restoration in my job. God, I need some restoration on my health. I need to be restored. So today we spend time sharing with our partners what we believe we've heard from the Lord. And so as we release our vision and commit as family members to bring it and be in place that we might be the ones, because the Bible declares that it's going to take some people to bring the vision to pass. Somebody say, talk about me now. But I want to remind you of what vision is and what vision does so that you can know for sure how important this is. Vision is the key to unlocking the gates of my then and my what can be. I'm going to try it again. Y'all see that? Vision is the key to unlocking the gates of my then and my what can be. Vision is the key that will help me understand that I got to move. Somebody say, I got to move. And where I'm moving to is bigger and better than where I am right now. Come on, prophesy right here. Where I'm going is far bigger than where I am now. So I got to have vision for where I'm going. And I need y'all to catch that today, that God is putting you in a bigger place. Somebody shout, thank you, Lord. So vision is that key to unlocking the gates of my then and my what can be. It's also the driving mechanism that helps me shift my gears and properly change my perspective and can propel me into possibilities yet unborn. I'm going to say it again because y'all slept on that one right quick. It is the driving mechanism that helps me shift my gears. Somebody says shifted. And properly change my perspective. Somebody say, I'm about to see this thing bigger than it ever been before and can propel me into possibilities yet unborn. I'm about to see some things I've never seen. Oh, I wish I had about five of y'all who felt that in your Holy Ghost. I'm about to witness some stuff I've never witnessed before, so I can see myself doing those things. Somebody say, you look good now, but I see you in your future. I see you walking in favor. Come on, prophesy and prosperity. Come on, tell them, say, I see you walking in favor. Oh, yeah, God, yeah, God, yeah, God. It's the driving mechanism that helps me shift my gear and change my perspective that can propel me into the possibilities of things that are yet unborn. Why is vision so important? Habakkuk helps me here. Because it speaks to, y'all catch this, vision is important because it speaks to an appointed time that will speak and not lie. I'm trying again. Vision is so important because it speaks to an appointed time that will speak and it will not lie. Yes. The Lord spoke to the prophet Habakkuk and told him to write the vision and make it plain that though it may take a while, somebody say, wait on it. I'm gonna try it again. Though it may take a while, somebody say, wait on it. It may take a while, somebody say, wait on it. He says, but it will surely come to pass when the Lord says it's time. Oh, that's a place to shout right there. Y'all don't even know when to shout. He says to the prophet Habakkuk, he said, write the vision, make it plain that though it may take a while, you wait on it. And I don't know who I'm speaking to right now, but God sent me to tell you that what you saw yourself doing in the dream and the vision, he has prepared you for it and it for you. I don't know who I'm talking to right here. God has prepared you for whatever it is you saw yourself doing, and it is ready for you to jump on the scene. Somebody say, prepare me, oh God. And how many of y'all don't mind waiting? I don't mind waiting on the Lord. I don't. Somebody shout, I don't mind waiting. Hallelujah. But I got to let you know and let you in on some things that as you wait for the vision to speak. Number one, if your vision is going to speak, you have to have an if you say so spirit resting on you. If your vision is going to speak, you have to have an if you say so spirit resting on you. The Bible declares in Luke chapter 5, verses 4 through 7, that Jesus says to the disciples, push out into the deep and let your nets down for a catch. And Simon says, we've been doing this already all night long, and we haven't even caught a small minnow. And I'm reminded when I read that in the text, when we went fishing, me and the three girls, and we went out there, and we went to fishing, and we tried to catch something, and all we did was caught the grass that getting caught in the hook. And so we didn't even catch anything out the water. But Jesus said to him, he says, listen, I want you to do this thing again. And he says, but if you say so. Peter says, I will do it if you say so. And the text says that when Peter said it, it was no sooner said than done, but a lot of fish filled the net. If God's going to do something in your life, you can have a strong belief that something big is going to happen in your life. Listen, if you have a vision and it's going to speak, you got to make sure that you have an if you say so spirit that's resting on you. If your vision is going to speak, you need to be connected to the revelation that God said it and I shall believe it. And he said, do it again. Somebody say, I'll do it again. Notice that the miracle didn't happen until the second time. Sometimes the miracles will happen on the second time. Somebody say the second time. The second thing I want you to know, if your vision is going to speak, you have to have, this is key, y'all, the right people in your life at the right time to experience the supernatural hand of God moving in your life. If your vision is going to speak, you have to have the right people. Somebody say the right people. At the right time, somebody say right time. For the supernatural, somebody say supernatural. See, the wrong people in the right season ruins the vision. The right people in the wrong season ruins the vision and the people. But the right people in the right season will experience the supernatural power of God manifested among the people. And you got to make sure that you understand that if you're going to have a supernatural move of God, you got to have the right folk around you. Somebody start looking around, you're trying to figure out who's, you know, saying who. Yeah, you got to know who you're walking with. You got to know who you're walking with. And the environment is so critical when you talk about vision, because your was then will compete with your now unto him who is able. I'm going to try it again. The environment around you is so critical because your was then will compete with your now unto him who is able. Can I say it one more time? If your vision is going to speak, you got to understand that your environment is critical because your was then will compete with your now unto him who is able. See, I used to be broke. But I've learned that God is able to provide wealth and riches in my house. And so my was then is going to compete with my confession that wealth and riches are in my house. So you got to be careful with who is around you. Yes, Lord, you got to be careful. Somebody say, I'm going to be careful. And I want to release this word of your life. Lift your hands right here. Let me release this word of your life. That God is planting the perfect people. He's releasing them right now into your personal space. And they have the proper process to align with your passion to produce something supernatural. I want to reach that again over your life. God is planting the perfect people, so they're not going to look like what you think they're going to look like. But they're the perfect ones just for you. He's planting the perfect people in your personal space. That means they're going to be able to get close enough up to you to hear what God is telling you to do. Mm-hmm. He's planting the perfect planting the perfect people in your personal space, and they're going to come with the proper process to allow what you're already doing, and you're going to receive the supernatural happening in your life. Somebody shout, Lord, I receive, I receive. And so not only if your vision is going to come to pass, number one, I told you, you got to have an if you say so spirit. Number two, you got to have the right people at the right time. But number three, if your vision is going to speak, you got to open your mouth. And y'all, we used to say and speak to somebody else, but I want you to speak to yourself. Because you're not going to have somebody around you at all times. Open your mouth and speak to yourself. The woman in Matthew 9, she said to herself, y'all better catch this morning, the woman who had the issue of blood, who had exhausted everything that she had a bleeding, and she was in a needing. She had a bleeding and was in a needing, and there was no need for her telling the doctor no more because she had exhausted all she had. There was no need for her going down to the local Walgreens and try to find the blue pack because she had a need that couldn't nobody meet. But she thought to herself, somebody said, you got to speak to yourself. The woman said to herself, I know, here it is, I've seen myself well and whole, and I've seen the bleeding stop, but if I can only just touch the hem of his garment, I know what I saw is going to come to pass. Sometimes you got to speak to your own self. Sometimes you got to prophesy to your own self and lay your hands on yourself and say, I call this thing healed in the name of Jesus. Sometimes you got to talk to your own self and say, this too shall come to pass. Sometimes you got to talk to your own self and say, I will not die, but I will live. Somebody say, I'm going to live. And so if your vision is going to speak, you got to open your own mouth and speak to yourself. And so today I came to share with you what I believe that God has directed us to accomplish in this year of restoration. I want to give you this quote that I found by Devin Franklin. He says, don't downgrade your dream to match your reality, but upgrade your faith to match your destiny. I'm going to try it again. Don't downgrade your dream to match your reality, but upgrade your faith to match your destiny. Can somebody give God a praise on that quote right here? Yeah, I'm not going to bring it down to where I am, but I'm going to release my faith to where I know I'm going. Somebody shout, I'm going somewhere. And so we release our faith, stand on the word of God, and believe that all things are possible. And so this year, we believe that we're going to receive some restoration in six areas. I'm going to give them to you rather quickly this morning. Somebody say six areas. We believe that we're going to see a restoration in our membership. And this is the declaration. If you're going to take a picture of it, you might want to go ahead and take a picture of it. But our declaration is our church is attractive to people, and they are guided by the Holy Spirit to connect with us as partners as we build God's kingdom in the earth realm. Our church is attractive. Y'all, there's somebody out there who needs what Victory has. And our church is attractive. Somebody say, our church is attractive. And so we are praying in this season, in this hour, that we will have the ability to have an anointing that was revealed to the people in Acts chapter 1, verse number 8. We're praying for an Acts 1:8 anointing. Somebody say Acts 1:8. And where we would have the anointing and we might be able to draw people. We declare a harvest of souls is coming to Victory Tabernacle Church International. We're going to be declaring a harvest of souls is coming from the north, the south, the east, and the west into our house. We're going to be declaring that all that we have received, we won't lose not one of them. We want to declare and decree that we will win the lost. We're going to make disciples. Somebody said, make disciples. And y'all, that's the difference in making a church member and a disciple. See, we got a bunch of church members, but we don't have a whole lot of disciples. See, disciples would do, I'm about to get in some trouble right here, but let me go on and step in it because I hear the Lord saying right here. See, disciples would give you every excuse and reason why not to do what they need to do in the kingdom. A church member would give you every reason why not to do what they need to do in the kingdom. But a disciple would say, I'll go. If it's raining, I'm going to go. If it's snowing, I'm going to go. If it's thunderstorm, I'm going to go, because the disciple knows that he is a student of Jesus Christ. And so we want to build disciples, and we don't want to build no more church members. We're praying that God of the harvest will send in laborers for the perfecting of the saints to edify the body. So one of our goals this year is to increase our membership. Somebody say increase the membership. Well, if we're going to increase our membership, the Bible says sheep beget sheep. That means that we're going to get some members into the kingdom of God. We got to do some work. Somebody said we got some work to do. The second area we believe that God is going to restore us is in our income. In our income. Somebody say in our income. Now, when I release this word over your life today, I want you to know that I'm talking about your personal income. Because we are a tithing, seed sowing, grace giving church. So we're going to believe God to restore our income. Psalm 112, verse number 3 declares, wealth and riches are in our house. Lift your hands. I want to release this over your life right here. That the favor of God. But God is raising up somebody. Yes. He's raising up somebody somewhere. Yes, Lord, release them now into the lives of your people. God, release them now. The favor of God goes before you and surrounds you as a shield. I heard it again. It's approved. I heard it again. It's approved. I heard it again. I heard it last week, but I heard it again. It's approved. Somebody stamp something, say it's approved. Somebody stamp something, say it's approved. Somebody stamp something, say it's approved. And so I declare and decree that God is raising up somebody somewhere who's going out of their way to use their power, their ability, resource, influence, and networks to bless you. Here it is, to the point that you become that somebody who pours into the bosom of other people. We're blessed to be a blessing. I also want to release this. And I don't know if I want to confess or repent. I've already done both of them to God, but I think I need to do it publicly. Because I've strayed away from talking about seeding into the man or woman of God. Because they told us when we grew up in church, that's not something that the pastor ought to be talking about. Well, I want you to turn your attention, if you will, to Philippians chapter 4. Somebody needs to receive this, because this is going to bless your life right here. Philippians 4, 17 through 19. Paul says, you Philippians well know, and you can be sure I'll never forget it, that when I first left Macedonia province, venturing out with the message, not one church helped out in this give and take of this work except for you. You were the only one. Even while I was in Thessalonica, you helped me out. And not only once, but twice. He says, I'm not looking for a handout, but I do want you, catch this, I do want you to experience the blessings that issues from generosity. He says, the seed that you sowed into me released a seed of generosity over your life. He says, when you sowed into me, there was a spirit of generosity that hit your life. I want to make sure I'm clear in saying this. He says, listen, I'm not looking for a handout, but I'm doing it so that you can experience the blessings that will come upon your life in a generous manner. And now I have it all and keep getting more. The gift you sent with me, the gift you sent with Epaphroditus, were more than enough, like a sweet-smelling sacrifice roasting on the altar, filling the air with fragrance, pleasing God to no end. He says this assurance to them right here. You can be sure that God will take care of everything you need. His generosity exceeds even yours, and the glory that pours from Jesus, our God and Father, abounds in glory that just pours out in eternity. Let me say this to you. you can be assured, this is all I said from that text, that when you sow into the man of God, that something supernatural will happen in your life. Now, this is a growing place for a lot of people. Because a lot of people think that, oh, the pastor must need some money. No, Paul said, no, I don't need it. And it's not really for me. It's for you that the generosity might spring open and pour open in your life. So it was for the giver. And so when I got the revelation on that, I start sowing. I start sowing into my apostle. Our ministry starts sowing. And we start sowing and we start sowing. And I want to stand today and testify that as a result of the seeds that we were sowing and the seeds we continue to sow, that there's a generosity spirit that has hit our house. I'm telling you what I know, not what I heard. There's a generosity spirit that has hit our house. And not only our personal house, but this household of faith. And I want to share with everybody right here, because we're going to get to the place where we're going to do the Philippians 4:19, where God is able. Yeah, God is able. Somebody say he is able. Somebody shout, God is able. But this is how he's able: once you put your seed in the ground, you can be assured that the generosity spirit is going to break out in your life. Area number three, let me go to area number three. Number three, we believe God's going to restore us in our connections with people in the community. We're partnering as the faith-based community with officials, and I believe God's going to open up the door, and they're going to want to know, what is it the Lord is saying for Henry County? I believe God's going to open up the door, that they're going to want to know, what is the Lord saying for Henry County? I believe the Lord has a word out of victory for the officials that will bless them and help them as they lead in our county. Number four, we believe God's going to restore us in the area of leaders and leadership. Hear this, if you will. In Exodus 18, we see what Jethro says to Moses. He says, you need some help in order to do what God has called you to do. And then we get in Numbers 11, where God says to Moses, he says, gather together 70 men from among the leaders of Israel, men whom you know to be respected and responsible. Take them to the tent of meeting and I'll meet you there. I'll come down and speak with you. I'll take some of the spirit that is on you and place it on them. They'll then be able to take some of the load of this people, and you won't have to carry the whole thing by yourself. I want to say that God is planting the proper leaders to surround the leadership so that the leadership can keep hearing from God. And the leaders can take care of those other matters. Somebody say, leaders, leaders. Yeah, we're looking for leaders who can carry forth the mantle of leadership, where they can just do it without nobody asking them. We're looking for leaders who will say, listen, I see that needs to be done. Can I take care of that? We're looking for leaders who will identify, hey, I see you tired. Go on, go over there and take you some rest. I got this part. And I believe God is raising up leaders. I believe God is raising up leaders right now. Number five. We believe God's going to give us an opportunity to be restored in our communities. Where we're going to live out the Matthew 25 mandate. Where Jesus says, when I was hungry, you fed me. Y'all, I believe that this is one of the mandates that's upon the church right now, that we've got to be in place to feed people. When I was thirsty, you gave me a drink. When I was homeless, you gave me a room. When I was shivering, you gave me clothes. When I was sick, you stopped to visit. When I was in prison, you came to see me. And I believe that God has given us the mandate this year to take Sundays like today and go out to the community and bless the people, because we're blessed to be a blessing to other people. And true disciples will come and bless other people. Y'all, we are Psalm 91 covered. So we're going to go out. Our last area that we believe God's going to breathe fresh on is our virtual church. Y'all, this is new to a lot of folk. This is new to a lot of folk. And to have to go virtual from being in a position where you've had fellowship and joy divine with one another has been major work. We believe God's going to breathe on our virtual church. And what we're going to begin to do is we're going to broadcast even more. And we believe that the way you're going to help us get that accomplished is that you're going to share it every time you get a notification that is out there. And so we don't spend time telling you this because we don't expect for things to happen. Y'all, this is going to be a great year for us. In six areas of our ministry, six areas. Somebody say six areas. And so today we're going to do our confession. And as we confess, I want you to believe what you are confessing. Would you stand all over the building if you are in your homes? Would you stand right where you are so that we can confess together? Would you stand right where you are if you're in your home? Y'all, we believe that our confessions are working on our behalf. Our confessions are working. Somebody shout, our confessions are working for us. Shall we confess together? We, the body of believers at Victory Tabernacle Church International, enforce God's original plans and purposes in our lives and in the life of this ministry. We are citizens of the kingdom of God, and we have what we say. We are doers of the word of God and not just hearers only. We are what the word of God says we are. We have what the word of God says we have, and we can do what the word of God says we can do. VTCI is prospering at everything it sets its hands to. I think I want y'all to say that again because we got some partners who we want to connect with us right here. Come on. VTCI is prospering at everything it sets its hands to. We have a great work to accomplish, and we command finances and all resources to come forth now without delay. Go back to that sentence again and say, we have great work to do. Come on, because we're going to command it to come now. We're going to command it to come now. Somebody, here we go. We have a great work to accomplish, and we command finances and all resources to come forth now without delay. We call in everything prepared for us before the foundation of the world that pertains to our life and the life of this ministry. The supernatural word of God is prevailing in every area of our lives. We are fighting the good fight of faith and laying hold to the eternal life. We are overcomers, and our faith is the victory that overcomes the world. Now, thanks be unto God, who always causes us to triumph in Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Somebody put a hand clap of praise on that right here. Come on, put a hand clap of praise on that right here. Come on, put a hand clap of praise on that right here. If you believe what you just confessed is going to manifest in our lives. God, we thank you now for your word that has gone forth. God, we've given you our vision. And according to Proverbs 16:3, if we give it to you, you will see to it that it will get accomplished in our lives. And so, God, we thank you now. We've confessed, and we do indeed believe. We give you praise now for moving on to our behalf. And, Father, we just ended a fast this weekend, and, God, we thank you now that doors are open for us. Yeah, God, we thank you now that things are being revealed unto us. We thank you now that ways are being made unto us. God, we need you to move like never before. God, do it for us like never before. In Jesus' name, amen, and thank God. If you are online or if you are here in the house today and the Lord has spoken to your hearts to connect with us here at Victory Tabernacle Church International, I want you to do two things. I want you to raise your hand online, and I want you to put online, I'm all in. I want you to raise your hand online and put, I'm all in. I want you to raise your hand online and put in, on the screen, I'm all in. And so we want to connect with you. that we might build the kingdom of God together here at Victory Tabernacle Church International. Somebody give God praise for the people that are coming. Come on, give God praise for the people that are moving. Somebody give God praise for the wonderful things that he's about to do with our vision right now. Amen, and thank God. Somebody say thank God. Somebody say thank God. Somebody shout thank God for the word of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Well, it is offering time in the tabernacle. It is offering time. Somebody give God praise for the offering in the house on today. Amen. We give God praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Good morning, Victory. Good morning. It's offering time. I know everyone is excited and that you get a chance to give again this Sunday. The last time I stood before you, I talked about the four ways of giving. The giving of alms, which is when you give to the poor without celebrating and telling the world. You're paying of your tithes, your seed offerings, and our grace giving. I taught you that you cannot get the full blessing of giving if you're not paying your tithes. So if you're not paying your tithes, all the money that you give is just going towards your tithes. And you're not reaching your seed offerings because that's where the blessing lies. Giving is not about money. But giving is truly about how much you love and trust God. And that's when we step into grace giving. Some people get caught up on losing or giving all their money away. But God is not trying to take nothing from you. He's trying to get something to you. But when you think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he has done for you, all that he has done for me, my very soul just gets happy. So giving should be just become automatic. When you can open your hands and allow the money to flow freely, everything will be okay. And that's when the blessings begins to flow. I just was just thinking about this afternoon. I was scrolling through Facebook and I ran across a post, and the post said that the family had a pre-funeral dinner, and from that dinner, COVID decided to be a part. And from that dinner, the cousins, the mother, the aunt, the wife, and that person who was writing that post are either in the hospital, getting out of the hospital, in ICU. And then I said, but the grace of God. After I prayed for that family, I thought about the grace, that unmerited favor, that hadn't been my testimony. And that's why grace giving is what we do here at Victory. I asked God then to heal that family. And I asked God, give me what you want me to give to keep my family covered in Jesus' name. It's all about the grace of God. How much do you love and trust God this morning? Trust him to give you what you need to give. Pay your tithes. Give your alms. And sow your seed this morning. Let's say our confession. We are Victory, a faith teaching church, a favor filled church, a praying church. We are Victory. a family church, a caring church, a mission-minded church. We are Victory, a tithing church, a seed-sowing church, a giving church. We are Victory, favor, increase, blessings, and doors of opportunity are our covenant rights as givers. This is our season of big manifestations as we step into our best faith-filled life. In Jesus' name, amen. There are four ways that you can give here at Victory. You can text to give at 404-996-0077. Or you can go online and visit our website at www.igotthevictory.org and then click the donate button. We have a mobile app with easy tithe giving. Just search for Victory Tabernacle Church International and give your tithes there. Or if you just rather drop it in the mail, mail it to 111 Kellytown Road, McDonough, Georgia, 30252. Get your seed in the ground.
Amen. We give God praise for the opportunity to sow a seed, because every time we sow a seed, we do what? Every time we sow a seed, we do what? Every time we sow a seed, we do what? Amen. Amen. We certainly thank the Lord for the seeds that are going to be sown. I was just standing there, and I have been reading Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse number 11. And it says, may the Lord God of your ancestors increase you 1,000 times more than he has promised. May the Lord God of your ancestors increase you 1,000 times more as he has promised. And we're going to sow a $111 seed on Deuteronomy 1:11. We're going to end this fast by putting a seed in the ground. $111 seed. Yes, $111 seed. We're going to put it in the ground that the Lord God may bless us 1,000 times more than he has promised. Y'all, God's doing it. See, when you have the word of God that you stand on, you can watch him do it. See, God's trying to get something to us. I heard her saying, not from us, but to us. And so we thank him so much for the wonderful things that he's doing. Deuteronomy 1:11. Go out there and read it. May the Lord God of your ancestors bless you 1,000 times more than he has promised. Somebody say, that sounds like restoration to me. That sounds like restoration to me. I ain't believing God to move in your life on the very first day of February, which will be tomorrow. Your month of February is going to be filled with mind-blowing movements of God. Oh, I received that fresh word from me, God. Your month of February is going to be filled with mind-blowing moves of God. So when the phone rings, y'all answer the phone. When the emails come, y'all answer the emails, because God's going to do it for us. For those who believe, all things are possible. Amen. All things are possible. Would you stand on your feet as we give God praise for this wonderful day? We thank him so much. We give him glory and honor for being our God. I want to say that I am grateful to God to serve, listen, and still be alive the first month of the year. And that somebody should have said something right there. I'm glad to still be alive the first month of the year in 2021, because in January there were a lot of people who could not say I've made it to February 1. A lot of people. Yeah, the song says all night and all day there are angels that are watching over me. And I pray in Jesus' name that the angels of the Lord that are assigned to you will keep protecting you and keep watching over you. In Jesus' name. Father, we thank you now For those persons who have connected with us, we pray now in Jesus' name for the new members that have connected with us. We thank you for our partners who are already members. Strengthen us now for the journey. And God, we thank you that this next month is going to be filled with some supernatural moves. We stand on it with expectation and we do believe it. We praise you in advance. The entire month, we receive it in Jesus' name. Now may the Lord bless you, the Lord keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you. The Lord be gracious unto you. The Lord grant you peace, love, power, and prosperity all the days of your life. In Jesus' name, somebody say amen. Amen. Before you all move, stay right there. I want to pray for you. I want you to record this. I want you to record this because what's going to happen after service on Sunday, I want there to be a section where you do something that shows this prayer. I don't know how you're going to do that, but figure it out. If we can work it out, we will. Would you lift your hands? Father, I pray now for every person who's in this room. Ooh, I pray for their life, their health, and their strength with long life. I declare and decree that you're satisfying them. I pray, I pray for their families. I pray that increase hits their house for the dedicated service that they've given during this season. I thank you, God, that you're loosing now the resources in their lives right now. And God, wherever there is pain in their body, we declare healing in the name of Jesus. Wherever there is direction that's needed in their lives, we pray that you will answer their prayers. And Father, we love you, we honor you, and we thank you, God. We give you glory and we give you honor. And God, as we leave this place, but never your presence, we plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. And Father, as they go home tonight, I pray they have sweet sleep. I pray that when they lay their heads on the pillow tonight, insomnia will not be their portion. But they'll just go right to sleep because they have their mind stayed on you. And so God, release a fresh anointing on their lives now. In Jesus' name. The people of God said amen. They said amen again. They shouted amen one more time. Oh, the angels keep watching over me. Oh, yeah, keep watching.